To destroy the Khilafah, you'll have to destroy the Ottoman Empire. And you cannot destroy the Ottoman Empire with 5,000 Jews in an army. You need a world war to destroy the Ottoman Empire. That's a tall order. So what you do is you plan a conspiracy. And you stay behind so that your fingerprints are not in the crime. In other words, you plan a September the 11th. Huh? In the summer of 1914, there were six major powers in Europe. And there was one dark force across the Atlantic. No one knew how fast it could run because it had never run in a race so far. One dark force across the Atlantic. And six major powers in Europe. They were number one, Russia, France, Britain, Germany, Austria, Hungary, that's five. What's number six? Ottoman Islamic Empire. These are the six major powers.
For the Ottoman Empire under Sultan Mohammed V was an alliance with Britain's much-feared rival, Germany. Together with the Austro-Hungarian Empire, these countries made up the Central Powers, and pitted against them were the three allies, Britain, France, and Russia.
The attack took place in the summer of 1914, when the Grand Duke Franz Ferdinand was assassinated in Sarajevo. They left footprints which led to Russia. And so Austria-Hungary had no option but to declare war on Russia. But Britain and France already had a treaty, a defense treaty, with Russia. And so Britain and France now had to declare war in favor of Russia against Austria-Hungary. But Germany has the same racial ties with Austria-Hungary, so Germany is now forced to enter the war on the side of Austria-Hungary. So they have succeeded. Whoever planned that assassination has succeeded in bringing all these powers now in Europe into a state of war. All that is left now is Ottoman Islamic Empire.
Treaties, alliances, ententes, everything seems conveniently arranged, permanently settled. And then, June 28, 1914, the heir to the throne of the Austro-Hungarian Empire, Archduke Franz Ferdinand, is assassinated at Sarajevo in the Balkans.
The Khalifa in Istanbul does not want to enter the war. He knows how weak the Ottoman army is in terms of military technology. But through internal intrigue within Istanbul, the Ottoman Empire is forced into the war, and a Russian ship in the Bosphorus is used as a pretext.
Ey Müslümanlar! Biliniz ki devletimiz İslamiyet'in Abdülvicahı olan Moskov, İngiliz ve Fransız hükümetleriyle muharip bulunuyor. Emir Ülvi'nin Hazretleri sizi cihada davet ediyor.
Once the war started, that massive wealth which the Jews had accumulated is now going to be used strategically for the purpose of influencing the direction of the war to get the prize that the Jews won. What is that prize? To destroy the Ottoman Islamic Empire, dismantle it, and to cut off the head of Islam, namely destroy the Khilafah. That's the prize they are. The next prize is to liberate the Holy Land and to get the Holy Land for themselves. German submarines had surrounded and marooned the island of Britain. The French government had fallen and Germany had occupied France and Britain was on her knees.
When the enemy finally withdrew, Constantinople was decorated from one end to the other. At night, the minarets were lit up with oil lamps. Everyone was full of joy. Pale faces began to smile. Constantinople came back to life.
This is the moment that the Jews were waiting for. Now the Sheikh is going to talk. It's called financial diplomacy. The Jews, this is the German Jews, went to the British government and said, let's make a deal. Let's make a deal. We will intervene in the war with massive financial assistance. Massive. And we will bring that dark horse into the race. But that dark horse didn't want to come into the race. American public opinion was overwhelmingly against involvement in the war. But when the Jews went to the British government and said, let's make a deal, the British government said, deal.
They were having trouble. See, Germany was already winning. And they didn't like the idea at all. And so these characters went over to the King of England and said to the King of England, now, you don't have to surrender. If we can bring America in on your side, if we can cause America to start fighting your battle,